The old town of Nablus in the West Bank. Shirin Nazal is a social worker. She is visiting families and villages south of Nablus where there are many Israeli settlements. Shirin encounters the same stress and anxiety during all her visits.
They are very tired because they couldn't sleep in the night. There is shift in the houses. The mother, when she is wake up, the father is sleeping. And after that, the father wake up, the mother is sleeping. Because they are worried from the settlers to go and to burn their house and or broke the house.
That's how life is in the occupied Palestinian territories. Everyone here remembers the 18-month-old boy who was killed when Israeli settlers set fire to his home. That was back in July. The incident has deeply affected Wissam Asseye's patients.
The people watch TVs to follow the news, what's happened here and there, especially on the checkpoints near the settlements. The clashes with the soldiers and the settlers, a lot of injuries, a lot of killed people, martyrs, a lot of arrestation, high numbers than compared with the other months. The people now follow all these news and start to have more anxiety, more sleeping disorders. The children focus with the families also on the news, and it affects their concentration and their school performance.
In the past few months, the violence has increased yet again, and the repression is even more merciless. The people aren't sleeping properly, not only because of nightmares, but also because of the Israeli soldiers who storm into their homes day or night to interrogate and arrest them, including adolescents like this boy who was arrested for throwing stones.
For young people, they experience these daily humiliations. Their economic futures are really shortened in comparison to other adolescents. They watch their fathers and mothers humiliated. They're targeted for no reason other than their appearance. And watching this day after day, you know, you can imagine for any young person how that might really get you down. And, you know, you combine that with, you know, impulsivity and maybe a tendency to answer back or to fight back. The consequences can be deadly.
Offering support to those suffering from trauma caused by a conflict they're powerless to do anything about, such is the daily task of the psychologists, social workers, and doctors working on MSF's programme.